Now that you've mastered the Grok processor, it's time to explore the other main processors and understand why they matter. If you're unsure or just want a quick overview, stick around. We'll cover them all in this video. Let's kick things off with remappers. Datadog offers many of them, but why are they so essential? Let's dive into some of the key remappers. I'll walk you through what they do and how to use them effectively. The logDate remapper helps convert a timestamp found in log attributes into the actual event time. By default, Datadog uses the timestamp when the log is received, but that's not always accurate. Logs are often generated slightly earlier, with their true timestamp stored in a JSON attribute. The logDate remapper ensures the log reflects the original event time, not just when it arrived. By default, Datadog inspects certain JSON attributes to determine the log level, like info, alert, or critical. But if your logs don't use the expected levels, you'll want to remap them. This way, Datadog can properly recognize and display the correct log status. Similarly, the service remapper ensures the service name is correctly recognized. If it's hidden in an attribute rather than a tag, this processor brings it to the forefront for better organization. The log message remapper works just like the others. It ensures the main message you see in Log Explorer is exactly the one you want highlighted. Sometimes the default message isn't the most useful. The log message remapper lets you choose which attribute should be displayed as the primary log message. This ensures your critical information is front and center. Plus, there are a few other remappers worth exploring too. Another useful remapper moves information from attributes into tags. Pretty generic, but powerful. Now let's talk about the trace remapper, focused on trace IDs and span ID injection. If your logs include a trace ID or span ID, remapping them makes it easy to navigate from a log directly to a related span. It ensures seamless, accurate traceability inside Datadog. Now to underutilized gems, the category processor and the lookup processor. They help you enrich your logs and make future searches faster and smarter. Let's break them down and see why they can make a big difference in your pipeline setup. First up, the category processor. It groups multiple values into easy-to-search categories. Simple, but incredibly useful. For example, you can group status codes from 200 and 299 into one success category, or 400, 499 into client error. Here's a quick example we can recreate together. In my log pipelines, I'll head to the Apache one we were exploring earlier. In this pipeline, we've already extracted the HTTP status code, in this case, 300. Now let's add a category processor. I'll select the HTTP code attribute and create a category for 400, 499 errors. We'll set the target as status code category and enter a simple query to define these ranges. You can see an example right here. Since we've already filtered 500s separately, we can focus here on other ranges. We're creating clear categories like 5xx and 4xx for faster filtering. For example, if the HTTP code falls between 500, 599, we'll tag it as 5xx. Similarly, 400, 499 gets tagged as 4xx. This processor automatically creates a new attribute, like code category, making queries much easier. Just set the rules, click create, and you're done. Now, instead of complex queries, you can simply filter by HTTP code category equal sign 4xx to see all 400 series logs at once. Great. Now let's move on to the lookup processor, another powerful tool worth mastering. The lookup processor works just like VLOOKUP in Excel. You provide a source attribute, like an ID, and map it to richer, more meaningful data. For example, you might start with just a display ID, but you can map it to a user's full name, address, or any other info. Just upload a CSV or use a reference table, and the lookup processor handles the rest. In this case, if the display ID 901 inches matches in your table, all related attributes like Andy's Ottoman's Michael Scott are pulled into your log automatically. This is especially useful for roles, like distinguishing admins from regular users. You can bulk assign attributes across all users without manually editing each log. It lets you enrich raw logs with context, highlighting whether a user is premium, regular, admin, or anything else critical for your analysis. Every IP you collect can be enriched with location data, like country, continent, and approximate city, using the GeoIP parser. The GeoIP parser is straightforward. Feed it an IP address. and it outputs detailed location info. Luckily, in our Apache example, we already have an IP ready to use. We already have one parsed IP, and I spotted another labeled network IP. That's perfect. We'll work with that one for this demo. I'll use the network IP field and rename it network IP test for clarity. This is the one we'll use for the GeoIP parser setup. Now I'll add a processor and select the GeoIP parser. Targeting network IP test, we can enrich the logs in just a few clicks, simple and fast. We've created the parser in seconds. IP input, rich location output. Heading back to Log Explorer, I'll clear any filters to check the results. Since we're focused on the source, I'll check the live tail to grab the freshest logs. Let's see if our network IP test shows up. Here it is, the enriched IP information is available. Just like any other attribute, I can now filter logs based on this location data. Within minutes, I can find all logs coming from the same location. Super useful for quick investigations. Next, let's talk about the URL parser. Whenever you receive URLs in your logs, this processor automatically extracts all the metadata for you. It works a lot like the GeoIP parser. Simply input the attribute containing the URL. The URL parser then extracts everything, no manual rules needed. You instantly get structured fields like scheme, host, path, and query string, all parsed automatically. And that's it for the URL parser. Now, let's quickly cover the pipeline scanner, a powerful tool to troubleshoot and speed up your log parsing. It's a powerful tool that's built right into Datadog. For example, with logs sourced from Apache, I can scan them all at once. The scanner will tell me which pipelines they match and where issues might be hiding. It shows exactly which pipeline each log matches, like pipeline 30 in this example. From there, I can drill down even deeper. You can click through multiple processors to see exactly where each log passed or didn't pass through the system. In this case, the log didn't match the category processor, likely because the status code didn't fall between 400 and 500, as we saw earlier. For example, this log had a 304 status code outside our defined error ranges. And that's it. Pipeline scanners are insanely effective. Use them often to debug faster and stay in control of your parsing rules. If you want to dig deeper, check out the official documentation on pipeline scanners. They're essential for spotting conflicts, fixing processing issues, and ensuring your logs follow the right path. Now let's tackle a feature that's often misunderstood: standard attributes. They help you standardize logs across teams and sources effortlessly. Let's learn how. You'll find standard attributes just after the pipeline setup. But what exactly are they, and why should you care? The docs have plenty of details, but here's the simple version you need to know. Standard attributes create consistent fields across all your logs, like error messages, HTTP methods, user IDs, or any custom field your business relies on. These attributes make it easy to search and filter logs consistently, no matter the source. Standard attributes work like aliases. For example, if different services log user IDs differently, user ID, UID, username, you can unify them all under one standard field. Of course, fixing things at the source is ideal, but if that's not possible, standard attributes let you map fields automatically. This way, in Log Explorer, you can search by user ID across all sources, whether it's Vector, Apache, Redis, your custom app, without worrying about field name differences. What is the source you'll be able to search through? Things could be from all the sources just mentioned. No matter how the original log was formatted, everything tied to that user becomes searchable and filterable in seconds. Standard attributes are powerful. They help you maintain consistency and structure across all teams and services. And that wraps up our deep dive into log pipelines with Datadog. It was a dense topic, but a strong configuration delivers massive long-term value. At first, it might seem overwhelming, but once you grasp the core concepts, it becomes surprisingly straightforward. I hope you found this tutorial both useful and actionable. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe and join our growing community for more deep dives like this. Until next time, happy monitoring.